YouTube, I'm Karan from India, and in this video we're gonna talk about how to make database in batch. So basically, for creating database there are three methods that I have analyzed yet. So you can either save database line by line, or you can save in the form of table. So under the table you can save it either using the table function or you can directly use the CSV files. And you know, a CSV file is an Excel readable format, and CSV stands for comma separable, something like that. And so there are only, I have used three methods to force creating database using batch, and I have decided to share it with you all. So let's talk about the first method, line by line. So I have created a new file, and let me open my folder, and here in the database I will edit it using Sublime. And as you can see, some lines of code I have already written. So these are default lines, echo off CLS and database tutorial. So for the first database, we are going to enter the data line by line. So we don't need to write this line, so I'm going to make it comment. And let's create a loop and set data is equal to empty, and then you take the input from the user. And for, as this is the redirecting character, so we need to use caret. And in the next line, I'm passing the variable value into the database file. Let's say it is temp.txt, and then again go to loop. You can save data in any form. So basically, for the line by line method, this line is important. You are entering data by using this line, so let me separate this line further. So this line is the main thing in the line by line method. So I'm going to save it, and as a newbie can say that what this program will do. So let me give you a little demo, and let me say hi, hello, how are you? And let me close this one. And in the temp.txt you will see all three lines saved in the database. So for reading this database, let's create another text document and name it as readdatabase.bat. And as per the type of the database you are creating, you need to modify the read database technique. So for reading this line by line method, you need a simple for loop, for slash f for the command you are going to apply. And it's better if you will take all the tokens so that it do not miss any wordings. Let me show you this by an example. So let me write the general syntax here. And if the file name contains no space, like this one, temp.txt, you can write directly temp.txt. And here let us echo the lines, echo %a. So all the lines in this temp.txt file. 1, 2, 3 will have one by one value of in, will save the value in this variable. So we are printing this variable. This means the until the loop is running, the variable changes its value first 1, 2 and 3, and it will print all the three lines on the screen. So let me pause it, and this, please wait for the next two methods, because these are the advanced methods and this one is for the beginners, so that's why I'm explaining little more than general. So just double click on the read database file and you will see all three lines on the console. So let us make a little create. So here create a loop, and without pausing it, give it a delay of 1 second, and this character stops the output of this command, and this one, this command will not show any output on the console now, but it will do its work in the background. So here we are updating the console screen every 1 second. So now we don't want to buy you. Okay, so let me run this file, and as you will see, after every 1 second this screen will get update. So where is the file? Now let me add few more lines in the database and you will see changes here. This is a YouTube tutorial and you are watching it. So this can be a hint to for your chat program. So you want to chat with your buddy. Here you can say hi fella, and your friend will see the message and he can reply you via the same technique. So you can save database and do whatever you want to do. So this was the first method of saving database and reading databases. And let's talk about the second method where we are using table. So instead of using table function right now, we are going to save the database in the CSV file. So simply we're gonna modify this file, and I'm going to make a table of, let's say, 2x2 or 3x3. So here I'm going to save it using for loops. So for, I forgot one thing to show you, what will happen when you won't use this tokens. So let me delete that and save that, control s, and again, now again I will go into read database and you will see a little change here that it is now reading only first word, first instance of the line before the spaces. So when you will open this file, you will see how are you in the third line, but in this third line you will see how, because it skips the line after the space. To eliminate that problem, you need to write tokens. So just say it to read all the tokens using star, and it will show you all the lines in the file. In the second method, we were going to use the for loops for saving our data. So it is a little advanced method and complex one. So have patience and give your attention. So let me give a comment here, creating a 3x3 table for database and here you will see 1, 1, 3. Do 4/L. I'm creating this loop for the sake of easiness, so that I can easily create database for the purpose of this tutorial. And here we'll do the same thing. We'll take the input from the user, and before that we need to clear the input value. So after clearing the data, you will see this one, and we need to write here %B. So you can see here that I have taken A and B here. So these two variables in the nested for loops can't be same. And here we need to write caret here instead of here. So it will show you the location of data, the location of data you are entering in the database table. So after getting all the three datas, we need to save them in a CSV file, because you can save in any format, but saving in CSV format will help you a lot. So here I'm going to save it, like say here data B. We need to separate the variables, and let's make another for loop here. C in 1, 1, 3. Do and set data is equal to and. As you will see that I'm going to set a variable inside the for loop, and there are nested for loops, so we need to enable the DEC condition. So set local, enable delayed expansion, and let us set the variables. We can't use percentages, so we need to use exclamation data and %C. We are going to combine this with the previous data value. As you will see that this data variable should not have any value before we are going to save it. So let's make it empty. So data has no value now. And here we are saving the data as overwriting the data variable. So let me take this thing in under the quotes, and these quotes helps in maintaining some bugs, as if your string will have some spaces, so the set command will take the everything as inside quotes as one thing, and it will not give you a bug for having spaces here. So it is just a safety precaution, so you should use it. And now we have saved it, and now let me delete that one. And for the same method, we are going to print the data value in the, as you will see there I have used semicolon, but we will gonna use comma here. So a comma will separate CSV file. So let's write as temp.csv and save it. And in the read database file, we just need to write here tokens is equal to star, and dalims is equal to comma. So the token will tell you that how many variables are there. So as you, we have created 3x3 matrix, we should know that we have created 3x3 matrix or the database table. You can say either table or matrix. I like the word matrix, so I will say matrix, 3x3 matrix. So here you should write 1, 2, 3 and then a star. So dalims will tell the for loop that from where you have to write three parts of the string. So the for loop will read the complete string at once, and you have told it to break it into three parts. And after breaking the into three parts, the for loop will ask you from where. By default, it will break it from the spaces, but we don't need to break it from spaces. We need to break it from commas. So we will break it from commas here, and here temp.csv file, and in the a variable. So we will write echo a, then a tab, then b, then a tab, then c. So it will print all the table, the whole table, one by one. So let's give it a try. Oops, it is giving me error. So we have done something wrong here. Forgot something. Back to back. So here I have forgot the in. And so let's give it a try again. So it is asking me now, please enter data you want to save. In the 1, 1 I will write 1, 1, 2 I'll write 2. So you will see a simple matrix. And now again it is asking me for that, because we have written loop here and it is again going to loop. So just close it, and as you will see here CSV file, if I will double click on it, and as it is readable by MS Excel, so you will see that after editing that the order doesn't matter, we need to set the order. So you will see that we have successfully saved database in the form of matrix or table. And so you can easily now you can easily edit or change the data using the traditional softwares like MS Excel. So now for reading the bat file, you just need to use this format, and it is the same as in the Excel. So this is another method of saving the database. So it is a table, and you can do it anything. Like, as you know that it is getting updated every time you are entering some value. So let's check that how they change. So let me write here. As you know that we have written everything in the order of 1 to 9, so but it is saving in a reverse order. So let's do one thing, and you will see another line added here, because we are not deleting the previous data, we are adding. So you will see new data every time. So to eliminate this problem, let's see what we can do. We just need to do this thing. Just need to write a comma here, and let's save it again, and again run the database file. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So let's close it and read the database. Oops, we didn't deleted the previous database. So let's do it again. After adding the matrix, let's read the database, and it is giving some error. I don't know why. Oops, we forgot that we cannot add comma first, because comma is what separating things here. So in the first attempt, data has no value. So the data the automatically this will get the first value, then the second value will get after the comma. So it was a logical bug. Let me delete this one first and let's test it out. Finally, close this one, read the database, and 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 as per we required. And when you will read it via MS Excel, you can read it here. Let's change the value of 5 to 50 and save the file. Control S, you can see it here. Yes, close it, save it. How many times I have to save? I don't know. Yes, yes, everything is yes. Read the database and you will see you have easily changed the value in the database. And this was the first and second method that we have used, simple newbie or a beginner's method for saving database line by line, and an advanced method using the CSV files. But in the third, using the table function. So I have not released the table function yet because it is still under, you can say, construction. Construction is not the word, I don't know. It is still under progress. So I am going to use the table function for the third method. So it will make things easier for you. You don't need to create these files. So you just need to save them in a table format, and the table function will output the file automatically. So for the table function, the last method, you just need to modify this file again. You just need to write here, let us create database file first, echo dot. So we're gonna read the data in the form of row. So let's create a file named temp.table. You can write any extension. I like the table extension for table function. And here we are going to create the 3x3 matrix. And we don't need to have these loops. We don't need these things. Yeah, we can directly save data now from here. My means the complex coding is gone. You can simply write simple things here. So just get the value and push the value inside the file. That's all. Get the value from user, push the values in the file, and the table function will do everything for you. So for reading the file, no need to write the for loop. Just write call table, and here I need to write this line in reading format. So delete it and call the table function, and this is the syntax of the table. So we are going to copy that, and where is the reading file, paste it. So we're going to paste the table at 5,5, and number of rows in the table, as we know, 3x3 matrix, so no rows and columns are 3x3. So width of one cell of the table should be, let's say, 8 characters, and height of one cell should be 3 characters, let's say border style of 1, and the color of the table, let it be 07, the normal color. And we know the table file is, the name of the table file is temp.table. So now you just need to save these files. As you can see, all shortcuts here I'm using. So let's create a database, and you will see a temp.table file is created. So the same thing we're gonna create as in the previous version, previous example. After 9, I'm going to close this one and reading the database. And here is something wrong. Hey, welcome back. So I found the bug. So it was due to that in the table.table file, you will see everything is saved as per the first method, line by line method, and the table function will do everything. So as we have created the database file, it was sending an extra space here before the row, but we don't need an extra space here. It was like that, so we need to close, delete that space, because there should be no space here as for the table function to work. And in the table function now, as I will close this one, and in the read database you will see that it has printed all the values as 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. So instead of row, if you will write here column as we need. Oops. So we need to write here getLen function. So let me grab the getLen function too, and I will see it here. Let me copy this one. And where is the folder? And you will see after writing this simple line column, so we need to separate, we need to divide this data in the form of columns instead of rows. So you will see the output as this one, and the output is already automatically formatted. So when you will write now table, and now let's, where's the data gone? The data has gone, because the moment we have run this database tutorial file, it has overwritten the previous data and deleted all the previous values. So now we're gonna add new values. So let me write one, and you will see that the line started coming here. It is not getting formatted because we have not changed the main code. So we need to change here, write column. It all depends on how we're gonna use this function. So I have written change the code, and let's see database and run the data, read the database along with the adding the 5 values. So let me add 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 and 9. So you can now change 10, 20, 30. And here we have told the table function that we are trying to set the data in the form of 3x3 matrix. So the data is longer than that, so the table function will automatically adjust the data, keeping the format same. So I think reading and writing the data using table function is much more easier than any other method, but you can use any method, depending on your wish and easiness. So here you can save again, once again you can save the database by 3 methods: a simple beginner's method line by line, an advanced method CSV file and readable comma separable variables, and advanced using the table function, advanced and easier version. So that's all for now. The tutorial is going long, so I have to stop it here. If you like this kind of tutorial, me explaining things in better way, so please give it a thumbs up and tell me about your views in the comments. I will like to know them. And thanks for watching. Please subscribe, please share this video with your friends, and bye bye. See you soon.